Today I'm going to show you some advanced stretching and release techniques for the subscapularis muscle. What's going on, everybody? It's Blake Bowman here with Gorilla Zen Fitness, and in today's video I'm going to be sharing with you some of the best release techniques and stretching techniques for a muscle of the rotator cuff called the subscapularis. To begin, the subscapularis is one of four muscles that comprise the rotator cuff, okay? And it actually sits inside of your shoulder blades. So if you picture your shoulder blades as two pieces of bone like this, two like small little walls of bone on your back, this is the back side of the shoulder blades, and this is the front side right here. There are a lot of things that attach and a lot of muscles located on top of the shoulder blades and a lot of muscles back here on the back part of the shoulder blades. The subscapularis is actually on the inside of the shoulder blades close to the rib cage. So obviously, just based on my description, the muscle is located in a weird area and it's kind of hard to get access to. Now, one of the main functions of the subscapularis is to internally rotate the arm, to turn it inwards like this, okay? Now, if you've been watching my videos for a while, then you know that I'll oftentimes talk about like upper cross syndrome, gorilla arm posture, and that's what this is, this internal rotation. So if you're somebody that, you know, works a 9-to-5 job, you're in this position a lot when you're working at a keyboard, you probably have internally rotated arms, okay? And what that means is that those muscles that internally rotate the arm are likely tight and overactive, okay? And the subscapularis is one of those muscles. You can check out the other video that I made on fixing internally rotated arms right over here. Realize though, many people have dysfunction in this muscle because many people have this postural distortion where they're turned in, okay? And if this muscle is commonly injured, the muscle itself, and even if this muscle doesn't become injured as a result of it being very, very tight, you might experience other injuries as a result of it being tight, like impingement syndrome, which typically comes along with this internally rotated posture. People will get, you know, pain and pinching right in here. So keeping your subscapularis muscle healthy, keeping it at a normal length, goes a really far way in keeping your shoulders healthy. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how to release it. With this first technique, I'm going to show you how to use your hands to get into this muscle, okay? And this is probably the easiest way to do it, to be honest. But basically what you're going to do is you're going to lift the arm on the side that you're looking to release up in the air, okay? This brings the scapula, your shoulder blade, into a position where it's more accessible, okay? And these muscle fibers are going to be more accessible. So I recommend just putting your hand behind your head like this, taking your other hand, wrapping it around the shoulder blade, okay? And then basically, right where my thumb is right now, this is where the subscapularis is, okay? Like I said, it's on the inside of that shoulder blade. So you're gonna get access to these lateral fibers, okay? The muscles are the muscle fibers on the side of the shoulder blade, basically. And that's what you're gonna have access to in this position, okay? So get your thumb, and you basically, I want you to kind of play around in here, put pressure in here, and feel this muscle. From here you can kind of get some active release by doing this with your hand. Okay, keep it lifted so you have access to that muscle. But basically this is what you're going to do. You're going to keep consistent pressure in there with your thumb. Kind of do like 5 or 6 pumps of this and then move up a little bit higher. Okay, you're really trying to dig in there with the thumb. Okay, but this is basically what you do. You can also experiment with different hand angles. You might want to like spear hand it in there like this, right? But just knowing where that muscle is and knowing how to release it, this is basically how you do it, okay? There's another way you can do it using a stick or a Theracane like this. And this is a little bit more aggressive, but what you can do is you can actually put this, the subscap, right on the end of this Theracane right here. Put it in there. You put the Theracane on the ground, and now I have all that, I'm controlling my body weight and allowing the Theracane to dig into that subscap muscle, okay? From here, same thing, you might want to internally rotate and externally rotate the arm to get a little bit of active release, but you're playing around with the position of both your hands and the theracane, if you decide to use this, to try to hit different muscle fibers. You know, more fibers up top, more fibers down low, off to the side. You want to release as much as you can, as much as you have access to. I would recommend you pick one of those exercises and play around with it on both sides for about 2 minutes, okay? You want to stay off of like lymph nodes and nervy areas. I'm kind of trusting that you have the ability to discern whether or not you're on a muscle or a lymph node, okay? So if you don't feel comfortable with that, then don't even try to do this. Seek a help of a sports massage therapist or a Rolfer. Okay, so now that we've gone over the pressure techniques, I'm going to show you a static stretch that you can actually use using a broomstick or a painting stick, any kind of type of stick, really. So this is a painting stick. Like I said, any stick works, but basically what we're going to do with this is we're going to externally rotate the arm bone, okay? That's how you stretch any muscle. You identify its function and what joints it moves in the direction in which it moves those joints, and then you do the exact opposite. So the subscapularis is an internal rotator, so to stretch it we externally rotate the arm, and a stick is a great way to do this. So basically what you do, you grab the end of a stick like this, drape the top part over your arm bone, your humerus. From here you want to plug that shoulder blade in, you want to plug that humerus in so it stays in the socket, and then you can grab the bottom part and apply this external rotational torque to your arm like this. Good posture here, keep that shoulder plugged back, lifting this, holding, okay? You're gonna hold this for about a minute, okay? You can even do a little bit of active release here if you want a little bit of contract and relax. Kinda torque your arm this way like you're trying to pull this thing over, just a little bit, like maybe a 25% contraction. And then relax and allow yourself to be torqued a little bit more. Contract a little bit, allow it to be torqued a little bit more. Keeping that arm bone plugged in the whole time. I can't emphasize that enough. I would recommend you hold that stretch for at least 1 minute or until you feel an actual release afterwards. There you have it. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you have and you're not yet subscribed to my channel, then go ahead and do that right over here. Also, to help me out on my channel here, it really, really helps when you guys give the video a like, you share it, and you leave me a comment down below. So I would really appreciate you doing that. If you have any questions for me or you want to see me make any videos in the future on any topic in particular, that comment area below is a great area to request them. Lastly, if you want to work with me, if you want me to be your coach and you want me to identify your postural distortions, your muscle imbalances, and then put together a custom program just for you, then go ahead and open up the description down below and hit coaching. Other than that, as always, I'll see you next time.